Our next topic is function calls. So far we learned to use call by value, which means we copy the arguments passed to functions. And here we see the example. We have our distance to midpoint function, where we have two formal arguments x and y. And here we fill those two arguments with actual values 3 and 4. So what will happen is then we call the function, those values get copied into the stack frame of this distance to midpoint function. And if I modify them here, any change will be local to the distance to midpoint function because it's a copy. So that provides some isolation, which is really nice, and it avoids accidental change of my program state, for instance, my value x and y here in the main function. Now what we can do, we learned that we can use an object that is a pointer. So we have here ptr is a pointer to an integer as an argument, but it would allow us to manipulate the objects outside of the scope. So here we had our example where we have a pointer, a value, and now when we have a pointer in the function, we can modify wherever this pointer points to, so it points to something in main, then we can change the value. What will happen in our example here is that even you call this function, note that we have now, in fact, we have basically one more variable. The ptr is still a variable. That means there's still something copied here. But what is copied is the memory address. Okay, so if our variable initially was on position 4, 7, 12, the moment I call the function here, I would copy this value 4712 into ptr. I can still change ptr, but this change would be local to this function, like it was here when we do a call by value. Okay, so any change to the variable and the object in it would remain local here. However, if we change whatever the pointer points to, we would escape this stack and would be able to modify here in this example something on the activation record on main. And this process we call by reference. Well, I think a more appropriate name would be called by pointers, but basically this value here, we are not accessing the value directly, we access a reference to this value or an alias. Okay, many programming languages like Java use the term reference because they don't allow you to access pointers directly, and that's probably where this term stems from, instead of, you know, using a term like call by pointer, right, which would make more sense. Right, so the idea for programming languages is that when you use call by reference, you pass in the original argument, and you are then able inside a function to modify this original data, so the original variable can be modified. It can only be used with trusted functions. And in C, this kind of call by reference is implemented using pointers. Right, so here is the Backus-Naur form, how you can use it inside a function. Well, we have a type, a data type, and we want to pass it by reference. Well, we have to declare its argument to be a pointer of this type. Note that you can mix and match call by value and call by reference. Like here in this example, I can have an argument, this is a pointer to a given type, and have another argument that is of a fixed type. It's not a problem, you can have as many arguments as you like. Here we see now an example call by reference again, where we take x and y to be pointers to doubles. And now if we calculate the midpoint, well, we can just divide wherever those two pointers point to by 2. And so we basically have two outputs from this function. One output is x and one output is y, but they are also input values because we use them. They are basically in-out values. Here we can see how they are used. Now we on main, let's assume we have two variables, x and y again for simplicity, and they have the values 10 and 12.5. So we initialize them nicely, and then we call this function calculate midpoint, and they get basically these pointers which indeed point to x and y in this example. And initially those values will be 10 and 12.5 because they are our values from the main function. Now when we divide x by 2, which happens in this line, what will happen is that our x that can be seen by calculate midpoint function, okay, this is what it can be seen in this function, is 5, but also the variable x in our main function has changed its value to be 5. Okay, then we do y divided by 2, whatever this function calculate midpoint sees, is now 6.25, but so is in main. Right, that these variables are now called x and y in both cases is a pure coincidence, I would say. You could have, we could have called them here z, a, or b, or whatever, and you know the name would be here different, but from the perspective of what would happen with the values, the same would have happened. Okay? And we have to remember that identifiers are really just used in C to describe a memory location, and at compile time, this memory location becomes defined. Right, so when we now call printf, what you will see is that we print x and y, which is now half the value that we have set here. So as you see, pointers in this case and call by reference has a little bit obscured the behavior of this program. It wasn't clear when we called calculate midpoint what this function really does. And in this case, it really has halved both of these inputs.